Hello and welcome. Thank you, Ron, for the introduction. My name is Gabe Levin, and I am a geospatial analyst and project manager at New Light Technologies. I'm very excited to share this presentation with you all, as it officially marks the launch of the brand new Geo4Dev website. To start off, I would like to present a couple of slides to introduce the purpose and audience of the Geo4Dev website, then I'll dive into a demo, and finally, I'll end with a brief discussion of our future aspirations for the website and opportunities for you to get involved. As previously mentioned, the Geo4Dev initiative aims to bridge the gap between development work and relevant geospatial analytical techniques and datasets. We identified four primary strategies for reaching these aims. The first is to promote the use of geospatial analysis in development projects by demonstrating how these geospatial solutions have enhanced development projects in the past, and to create learning material to make implementation of these solutions as straightforward as possible. The second is to promote a platform for sharing relevant research tools, publications, training materials, and data that is specifically designed to connect development workers and researchers with the most relevant information. Thirdly, we aim to act as a bridge for connecting the tools and resources of the private sector with the needs of the public sector. And finally, we hope to build a large, engaged, and welcoming Geo4Dev community centered around sharing ideas for how geospatial analysis and data can help enhance development work, foster new collaborations between communities, and maximize our positive global impact. To match the interdisciplinary nature of the international development field, we strive to build a strong community of development workers and researchers in governments, for-profit organizations, NGOs, policymakers, and universities with an interest in enhancing their work with state-of-the-art geospatial solutions. Creating such a global community poses some interesting challenges. Not only do we strive to reach across disciplines in the development field, we also want to reach across community and continental boundaries and create useful resources for newcomers to the field of GIS and remote sensing, as well as seasoned experts. We believe that free and open source tools give us the platform we need to foster collaboration, disseminate new ideas, and build a global Geo4Dev community. So now, let's take a look at the brand new Geo4Dev website. You can find it at www.geo4.dev. The primary function of the Geo4Dev website is to share an extensive library of geospatial resources catered specifically to development workers and researchers. Geospatial data and research are more readily available than ever before, but for a casual observer of the field, the rapid changes in state-of-the-art analytical techniques and available satellite imagery can be difficult to follow. There are catalogs available online that share new advances in the field and commonly used datasets, but these platforms are not always specifically designed to share information relevant for development projects. The Geo4Dev website houses an extensive, open data, and crowdsourced library of links of relevant geospatial publications, datasets, online courses, capacity building material, workshop recordings, and web applications that are curated specifically for development workers and researchers. We made all efforts to ensure that accessing this library is quick and navigating its contents is intuitive. On the front and center of the homepage, you can find a search bar and a drop-down menu called Categories. This is where you can search for relevant datasets, tools, and studies. Clicking on the Categories drop-down reveals a list of primary and secondary categories. The primary categories include health and emergency response, environment, governance and management, demographics and socioeconomics, land use and land cover, and monitoring and evaluation. All the content within the library is organized into these categories, allowing users to filter the library by their desired field of work. Additionally, the drop-down menu contains links to our featured learning material and featured dataset pages. where we will share new and exciting online courses and new open source datasets. The same menu can be accessed from any page using the categories dropdown on the toolbar. When a category is selected from the dropdown menu at the center of the page, the website redirects the user to the content library page, using that category as a filter, as seen by the filter menu at the top left-hand side of the page. The menu bar on the left also reveals other available filtering options, such as the content type, which includes publications, datasets, online courses, capacity building materials, workshop recordings, and web applications, and by the country in which the content is located. Of course, not all content will be country specific, so these items are included in the global category. Further filtering options are seen at the top of the page. There, you can find a search bar which displays the content that has the given word or phrase anywhere in the metadata. For those of you familiar with web development and open data portals, this entire website, including the database, is built on the CCAN open source data sharing platform. This allows us to integrate some exciting crowdsourcing functionality to our database, but more on that later. Clicking on an item in the library reveals a separate page containing all the metadata associated with that item. This includes the full text, an abstract, a link to the item source, the authors, location of the study if applicable, and much more. Beyond the curated content library, the Geo4Dev website is also designed to foster a global community. Using the About button on the navigation bar at the top of the screen, users are able to access the About page describing Geo4Dev, our partners with links to their websites, and what people are saying about Geo4Dev and the website. As Ron mentioned in his talk, we are looking forward to adding additional partners and collaborators. Please reach out to us at info@geo4.dev to get more information on how to become a partner. We also have a conference button where we will share information on this and other Geo4Dev related events. The tools page houses Geo4Dev's first unique tool, a geographical publication browser that shares the publications within the database on an interactive web mapping application. This map allows users to browse the database's contents by geography to help users find research related to development and geospatial analysis in their area of interest. Clicking on a marker on the map reveals the title, a brief description, the authors, the category it has been sorted into, and a link to the publication in Google Scholar. This application provides users a unique approach to finding relevant studies and gives users the opportunity to find other researchers working in the region, which opens up the potential for increased collaboration. The map also allows users to change the base map and filter the content by their desired content categories. So this is our website as it stands at the time of our symposium, but we have big plans for the website in the coming weeks, months, and years. Let's step away from the website demo and return to our slides so I can share our future development plans. As we touched on earlier, we are very excited to involve the Geo4Dev community in the development of both our database and our website. The database is built on an open data portal called CCAN. This platform allows users to create a profile through our website and ultimately contribute content to the database. When his user contribution is made, it will be reviewed by the Geo4Dev team and then made public on the website upon approval. This will be a crucial step in ensuring that our database remains relevant in the months and years to come. It also gives the Geo4Dev community an opportunity to share their own work or other content they think may benefit the community. In the coming week, we also plan to open our GitHub repository to the public. This repo contains all the code of our website and enables the possibility for developers in our community to contribute new pages, events, and tools to our website. This tool will be an important aspect of ensuring that our website continues to grow in utility and stays relevant as the technology around geospatial analysis, development, and web applications continues to evolve. Finally, we plan to someday include an online forum and blog on our website. This would be a space for our community members to ask questions, share insights, post collaboration opportunities, and help each other maximize our positive global impact through the integration of geospatial solutions into development projects around the world. Thank you so much for listening, and we hope to hear from you soon.